heard Mr. Bloom play. It was 1934, my first week at the Curtis Institute. And after my flute lesson with the great William Kincaid, he said, "I hope you're coming to the concert tonight, because it's an all Wagner program conducted by Leopold Stokowski." The rest of these students were given tickets, along with me, to go to this concert. It was the first time that I heard Robert Bloom play the English horn. He was the star of the show. Well, it took 10 years for me to be able to call him Bob Bloom. I met up with Bob in the Bahari group in 1946, and it's been a thrill for me. I think I'm a very lucky guy to play with Bob Bloom in the Bahari group and recordings. And what can I tell you about Bob Bloom that you don't know? But since I'm the first speaker, I'll make it very short. You're going to hear a lot of speeches. Again, where is Bob?
Why they want to pursue a career in music. Even in the early days of the school, which in 1927 had been flourishing for just 3 years, this question was part of a very brief application process. Bob's answer showed the directness, enthusiasm, and vigor that we saw in January of 1988, over 60 years later. The question, what is your purpose in studying music. The direct answer, to become an oboe player, conductor, composer. Mary Louise Curtis Bach and Joseph Hoffman, the guiding forces of our school at that time, stated that the goal of the Curtis Institute of Music was, quote, to hand down through contemporary masters the great traditions of the past. Bob's direct, no-nonsense answer, coupled with the lofty ideals of these two movers and shakers, has provided inspiration to several generations of artistry. The great oboist, Marcel Tabuteau, was Bob's teacher at Curtis and the source of what many call the American School of Wind Playing. His initial two-word assessment of Robert Blum on September 30, 1927, certainly has proved accurate. Under the category Estimate of Talent on the audition form, Mr. Tabuteau wrote, very promising. Today's event is proof that the promise has been more than fulfilled. On behalf of our students, alumni, faculty, board of trustees, and our artistic director, Gary Grafman, the Curtis Institute of Music wishes Robert Blum a happy 80th birthday.
Thank you. God bless you all, and thank you, thank you, thank you. And I'll see a lot of you later.